Make sure all preparations are complete and vessel is ready to move. Deck cargo and machinery has to be secured, doors should be closed, etc. All according to the checklist and the other videos which are explaining what and how to do it. Last thing to do is gangway removal and securing the crane. After the PA announcement, we will start jacking the hull down. Observe and measure the air gap and report measurements to bridge officer. When hull touches the sea surface, it is a key moment, so watch closely and report it. Once the hull is submerged enough in the water, engineers will switch the seawater supply from submersible pump to sea chest. Submersible pump delivers seawater while vessel is elevated. But as soon as the hull goes into the water, pump is retrieved into the coil and secured. Captain and chief engineer will test the propulsion, thrusters and go through all the items on the checklist. When tests have been completed, chief engineer will try to pull the legs out, and the legs will not move at all, because they will be stuck in mud. Buoyancy of the hull is not enough to overpower the weight of the mud sitting on the legs. Chief will try to pull the legs anyway. Lots of thinking and experience is involved, along with some head scratching, a bit of nail biting, hair pulling and of course angry looks at the checking screen. After all these methods fail, he will decide that jetting is required to release the legs. To start with the jetting, he will have to call some really smart people to help him. First we need to find the plug and unscrew it with special tool, as you can see here. Once the plug is out, we need to screw in the fitting. Might be elbow or straight, depends. Report the progress and carry on to hose connection. Connect the hose should look like this. You can see how it is connected to the piping system and butterfly valve number 2. This is how the water is supposed to come from the system through the hose and into the leg. Open that butterfly valve and go down. On the main deck, near each leg, there's a check valve, number 1, and pressure gauge. This is where we observe the water pressure while jetting and report any changes to the bridge. Since we already opened butterfly valve on the leg, we just need to open this one and water will flow through the system under high pressure. You can see the water is going through the open butterfly valve into the leg, pushed by pressure of the pump. Soil around the leg will start to liquefy. losing its density and weight, it will allow the leg to be pulled out. Draft will change and that will tell us the whole thing was a success. Chief engineer will not be scratching his head anymore because he will use both hands to operate the moving legs. Legs will be pulled out slowly and you might see bubbles on the surface or even a whole lot of mud. Those really smart people will reappear again. You should close the valve, drain the pipe and climb up there to disconnect the hose from the leg. Make sure hose is not pressurized and it can't hurt you, and disconnect it from the fitting. Find the plug and screw it back into the leg, like Boson is doing here. Carry on to secure all items around and clean up your mess. Once you're done, report to the bridge, so they know it's safe to proceed with raising the leg. Captain will safely move the vessel away from the platform, while Chief Engineer is pulling the legs up away from the seabed. This video is dedicated to my dear comrade Vlad, who is scratching his head in this movie while also being a Chief Engineer.